The newly rebuilt Holloway has some of the best prison educational facilities in Britain and a staff of 7 full-time teachers. Most of the time, the teachers are idle, the classrooms empty. The facilities cost the taxpayer £150,000 a year.
There are staff sitting around waiting for the prisoners to turn up to teach them. I visited Holloway Prison before Christmas. It's part of a review that we're carrying out, and I'm visiting all the 5 inner London prisons. And I was horrified because on the day that I visited, there was no education going on at all.
What do you feel about it then?
Well, I think it's a great misuse of public money.
Ilya say the 310 women at Holloway are being deprived of teaching because of industrial action by the warders. The Home Office deny this and say there are not enough prison officers to escort prisoners around the jail. They don't explain why. Over the last 10 days, 12 out of 30 teaching sessions have been cancelled. The effect on the inmates is predictable.
They desperately want to get into education. It is one of the few forces for good in a prison.
Sometimes they tell you that there's education and the women actually don't get let out for education, and no one comes along and says that there's no education. I mean, women are actually sort of sitting there waiting to go to education and then there's none.
Holloway used to have a fine reputation for its teaching facilities. Now prisoners claim that the new governor, Joy Kinsley, gives education a very low priority. 15% of the women prisoners have a reading age below that of a 10-year-old. Ilya regard the affair as catastrophic.
And I think it's a scandal that the public money of this order is being completely wasted because the prisoners actually inside the prison aren't getting access to the excellent staff and the excellent teaching accommodation that's provided.
Simon Neave at Holloway Prison for Thames News.